If you have a picture of the graph of the function, you can find discontinuities just by looking for breaks in the graph. These could be point discontinuities like this, jump discontinuities like this, infinite discontinuities like this, or endpoint discontinuities like this. When you're tracing the graph from one side to the other, if you ever come to any point where you have to pick up your pencil in order to keep drawing the next section, then there's a discontinuity at that point. When you have an endpoint like this, it's discontinuous because the general limit doesn't exist. The right-hand limit exists because as we trace the graph from the right side toward the left, we approach a value of 2. But there's no left-hand limit because there's no graph to the left of this point. And since there's only a right-hand limit and no left-hand limit, it means there's no general limit. And since there's no general limit, the function is technically discontinuous at the endpoint. When you have an asymptote on the end like this, there's no discontinuity at this point. The function is still continuous here. In order for there to be a discontinuity at an asymptote, the graph has to exist on both sides of the asymptote. And since the graph does not exist to the right of this asymptote, there's no discontinuity here. So what if you don't have a picture of the graph, but you have the equation of the function itself? Then how do you know where the function has discontinuities? Well, rational functions, which are fractions with polynomials in the numerator and denominator, like all of these, are the most common types of functions to have discontinuities. Because fractions are undefined when the denominator is zero, any value that makes the denominator zero is going to make a discontinuity in the function. If the zero value can be canceled out of the denominator, then it's a point discontinuity. If it can't be canceled out, then it's an infinite discontinuity. If we take this rational function as an example, we can see that it'll have discontinuities at x equals 2 and x equals 6, because both of those values make the denominator 0. If we factor the numerator, we can cancel out the x minus 2, but not the x minus 6. Because we were able to remove the x minus 2, it means that x equals 2 is a point or removable discontinuity. Since we couldn't factor out the x minus 6, it means x equals 6 is an infinite or non-removable discontinuity. If we sketch the curve, we can see the point discontinuity at x equals 2, and the infinite discontinuity, which is just a vertical asymptote, by the way, at x equals 6. You can also get discontinuities from piecewise defined functions. For this piecewise function, y equals x defines the curve to the left of x equals 3 and at x equals 3 itself. And y equals 4 defines the function to the right of x equals 3. If we sketch these curves, we can see that there's a discontinuity at the breakpoint of x equals 3. So to summarize, if you're looking for discontinuities in the function and you have a picture of the graph, just look for any point where you have to pick up your pencil, or look for endpoints, and all those points will be your discontinuities. If you don't have the graph, but your function is a rational function, look for values that make the denominator zero. These will be point discontinuities if you can factor them out, or infinite discontinuities if you can't. If your function is a piecewise function, then look at each piece separately for discontinuities, but make sure to look also at the breakpoint between the conditions. If the functions don't meet each other at the same value, then there's a jump discontinuity at that point.